Right, welcome to IT Idiots. It's episode 54.
I think so.
I can never remember which episodes we're on. But I'm Nicholas Hill.
Nicky Curtis.
And depending on which show you're watching, you're either watching in high def.
Or pan and scan.
Or pan and scan. So for those of you out there who think that it's because we've got a bit of a crap editing going on, it's kind of true. Because what we decided is that HD's the future, and that's where we're going to put all our time and effort, isn't it?
Yeah, so the best podcasts to get are the high-definition ones.
Well, anything by the IT Idiots TV
Anything
network.
By IT Idiots TV, but the high-def ones, if you're not getting the high-def ones, what you're doing is, what you're getting is a pan-and-scan version of the high-def ones. So, obviously, we don't really care too much about that format.
What about you?
So, it's really as good as you get, really.
Because essentially what we have to do is I have to pan to where there's some action on the screen, and obviously...
It's normally over my side.
And above the video, so that's what's going on with that. But obviously we appreciate that some people want to watch it on those little tiny devices sat on the back of an aeroplane.
It's true, no. But no, there's a point, I think, iPod Touch and...
Yeah, so anyway, this week we thought we'd do our episode on this high-definition camcorder that we've been going on about.
Yeah, so you actually got, and you're not seeing it at the moment because it's there. So you're watching a glorious low-def. Because
we needed the camera,
and we didn't have enough mirrors to do a good job.
No. And last time I tried doing a Skycam on something, I just got berated.
Yeah, you got slagged off there.
I did. So you can't win, can you? So apologies.
Do people know we've actually got a full-time job, Nick?
I have no idea. No, I think the one thing I want to convey to those out there, and we do like feedback, and we don't mind criticism, but it's got to be within the boundaries of the fact that Nicky's just turned up. We've just turned that camera on. And we're recording. So yes, there are going to be some limitations in terms of the quality of what we do and the quality of what comes out of our mouths.
Sure.
But we don't do this full time yet.
Not at all.
No, so...
I think it'd be boring as well if it all went according to plan.
Yeah, possibly. We'd have to then start scripting.
Exactly.
And that'd take even longer. So, so we bought this camcorder. And it's the one that I think the Twit Network have been going on and on about this.
It's one that Steve Jobs mentioned in his, I forget what event it was, announcing something.
And it's just been replaced.
Okay.
By the SD5. But so this is the reason why we went out and bought this one right now, because the things that this has got that we really wanted that the new one hasn't, it's got a larger CCD, uh-huh. So it's going to be better at capturing and produce less graininess in darker surroundings, which I think is good. And it's also got something which all cameras seem to be losing very, very quickly. And that is, if we open this up, something which all podcasters need, and that's a mic in.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Christ, what's the microphone plug? Oh, it's in that one. So it's got a mic in. So for us, as podcasters, we couldn't buy a camcorder without one, could we?
No, it wouldn't make our life eat.
It would make our lives a lot of hassle. So it's quite small and light, isn't it, mate?
Yeah, it's nice.
You haven't seen it, so
I haven't seen it
have
at
a play
all.
With it. Whilst I sort of talk about it. Well, so we thought, yeah, let's go and buy a high-def camcorder. The better what goes in, the better what comes out.
So we've got 5.1 surround sound as well.
It does, it has surround sound built in, not via this microphone.
How does that work?
I got it on stereo when I was playing around with it. So essentially what we're doing is we're capturing in 1440 by 1080. So it's quite a lot of pixels.
It is.
And what makes these cameras really, really unique is the fact that they're actually capturing, dude, onto a little SD card, 4 gigs of RAM.
What are they? What type of card do they use? That's
They're miniature.
They're not SD though, are they?
They are. They're the new standard of SD.
Exactly. They're, so I couldn't put that in a Wii, for argument's sake.
Oh, you could put it in your Wii. It's just that what you have in your Wii wouldn't be so good in here.
Okay. Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah. So show the girls and boys.
We need the Skycam.
No, because then I'll get told off for doing such a crap job. But I think what it's got is it's got uber fast read and write.
Gotcha. And that's 4 gig, and you get that with the camera, do you?
You do, yeah. You can buy 8 gig ones, but I think they're sort of about 10 times the price of buying 2 4 gig ones.
Okay.
So the camcorder itself comes with the ability to record in sort of 3 qualities of mode. I mean, I can actually turn it on so that you can at least see, even if they can't. So, card door open. Card door shut. So what we can actually do is we can go into this thing and we can set it up with a number of different sort of video settings. So you've got 3 different qualities, HF, N and E. And depending on which one you choose, you'll get a different amounts of recording time, because adjust the quality. So on HF, which is the highest quality, you're getting about 40 minutes on 4 gig.
Okay, that's
not bad. Which is very good, really.
Yeah.
And on the middle quality, somewhere around about an hour and 10 minutes. So an hour and 10 minutes is perfect for our overshoot waffle before we've cut down on any editing. So it's perfect for a show. But the nice thing about that is that we go out and about and capture some footage. I can actually now store the raw footage on my computer, which to me I thought would be a great idea to be able to keep some of the back episodes.
So what is it? Is it just a file on that card then?
Yeah.
Just a single file? Yeah. And you just drag and drop it onto your...
Exactly. Okay. So it's all in digital format, so there's no sort of loss, you know, by recording onto tape and then transferring from tape, which even traditional HD, even though it's not been around for that long, has been doing. Remember when we went looked first Sony, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was still recording onto tape. It was just recording a digital signal onto that tape. So do away with all those moving parts. The other benefit we're getting is much longer on the battery life. So I went out yesterday and did a number of filmings, and I still had, I mean, it hardly touched the battery after sort of half an hour. So
okay.
All in all, really quite pleased with that. Now, those are the good points of the camera.
Okay, and the bad?
Now, the bad points are, and I'm so glad we've only just bought this, because if we'd bought this before now, I'd have been so embarrassed of explaining to you why we can't actually use it for the show. Because obviously, if you've got 4 gigabytes of RAM and you're looking at recording even 40 minutes, that's an awful lot of compression in high definition.
Yeah.
To compress 1440 by 1080 into that amount of space. So what it does is it uses AVC HD, which is, to you and me, it's H.264, so not particularly new as a format, but it's a lot of processing power to do in high def without losing any detail.
Mm-hmm.
So up until now, there's really been nothing about to allow you to edit it or do anything with. So, which kind of
the software you get with it, that's no cock, no?
No, it's pants.
Is that okay?
It allows you to view it.
Is it a bundle? Is it Panasonic written or something?
Yeah, it's some in-house. It converts it to ordinary, burn it to a DVD.
Right, okay.
So whilst you'll get a superb DVD from that, because the scaling down from such a good, glorious input, it still makes it a bit pants.
Yeah, and you can't really edit it, I suppose.
No, so I'll tell you what, let's hook this up to the Pooter and let's take a look. Yeah?
Yep.
What do you think?
Sounds good.
Sound good to you? So it's USB. That's USB. And we literally just hook it up to the computer. Turn this little baby on. Put it into PC mode. So that noise you can hear is the lens shutter, it opens
right, okay.
And closes, so you don't have to keep remembering to stick something on, which to me is good. So that's really now hooked up to the computer. So at this point, I went out and I had to purchase something called Pinnacle Studio. And the reason I purchased this was, I mean, it looked very nice on their website.
It's a nice box.
It looked like a fantastically powerful editing tool for more powerful movies, and I thought, bargain, £59, and as you say, it's a nice box.
Nice box, yeah.
It's pants, dude.
Is it really?
I'm going to show you, but don't take this the wrong way. It's like iLife.
Right. Okay.
Sorry, iMovie. It's just drag something in and shuffle it around a little bit, put some transitions and put it out, which I guess is fine for home movies, but trying to convey that it's some sort of pro tool.
It depends what you want to do. I don't know if we'll come onto this later, but the iMovie
perfect for quick sort of,
yeah, for lots of people. I think that's all they need. I
yeah.
mean, certainly I wouldn't need to combine multiple streams, and I think when we're talking about this, obviously we want to create a podcast with it.
Correct.
So we want to have decent editing with it.
Yeah,
but I think
for home movies, if I was on holiday using this camera,
yeah,
I would use iMovie.
You'll get a movie in about a couple of minutes, won't you?
Absolutely. And in fact, anyone who watches the Mac show,
oh yeah,
we'll see this, because okay. We might as well milk this for all it's worth.
I suppose so. Yeah.
So I had to go out and buy this. So let's take a look at that. Now the first thing I noticed about Pinnacle is that it's a bit basic in what you can do. But again, fine if it's your home movie. But what it does have, and the reason why I went out and bought it, is import from media device. And this is so important in terms of...
It hasn't seen your camera.
Why not?
got it on the right spindly diode on that.
I thought so.
I'm not that narrow to use it, I'm just assuming it's like...
Yeah, it's on PC.
But it's a Mac. Put it on Mac.
Shut up. I really hope I didn't delete everything that was on here. Ah, sorry. Okay, yeah, no, that's a very good point. Thank you very much, camera. The camera's telling me what I did wrong.
You didn't plug it in.
Well, it brings me on to the next point. And that is the fact that you've got to have this thing, which is its power adapter. Now, you drop the battery onto here to charge it, yeah? But to charge the battery, this is one of my gripes, you've got to remember to take that out, because it obviously senses that, even though this isn't connected to the camera necessarily, so it doesn't charge the battery. Right, okay. So that pissed me off, because I put that on to charge, came back, and then found I hadn't removed that. And the next thing is, you've got to be running it off the mains to be able to connect it up to your computer, otherwise it basically says... I'm not going to do that. Okay. It kind of annoyed me a little bit.
So. Fair enough, I suppose. With lots of data, you could get corruption. What was that bang?
That was me connecting this to the mains.
You get it with those. Don't worry about it.
It just doesn't make a very nice sound. Right, it's so...
It was the water that did it.
It's the water. The leakage. Right, so let me just turn this off. I will do that. Pop this open. And... that up. Right. So hopefully this time, what's that going to tell us? PC connection mode. Right, so...
It's looking good.
It's looking good. Let's now ask the computer what... just look nice on screen. Right, so let's go to File, Import Media from Device. Ah, that's better, isn't it? So these are all media files. So what we can see here is that we've got 19 seconds and it's 13.5 megabyte file. 6.5 minutes, 7 minutes, 629 meg. So really, for high definition, it's not bad at all.
This is all you mucking around in your car yesterday, yeah?
I'll spoil it for everybody. I went out and I made a home movie, well, maybe they might have downloaded that one first.
Might have done.
So anyway, what it allows me to do is I can select any of these files and I can see which ones I want and I can choose to import it. So if I select that one and do import, and what it's literally doing is it's copying it across onto my computer. So I'll get all of those across and we'll then take a look. So if you give me 1 second, we'll be back when they're all imported. Right, so what I've done is I've got all of these HD files and I've now got them onto my computer. So what we can actually see is we can see a little description here. They were captured at 1440 by 1080, H.264 codec, 25 frames a second. So what I can now do is I can now drag these into my timeline. And I'll just drag down to the... Oh, yeah. Oh no, I've got a capture going on as well.
Oh no, here comes.
Oh, here we go.
Oh.
You bastard.
Is the capture still going?
Yeah. Right, so I dragged that into my timeline, and as you can see, it was a little bit sluggish doing just that. But what I can now do is I can drag the scrubber around, and I can play this file. Now, what's quite amazing is that is... requiring super amounts of processing power. Entry level for Pinnacle to do HD editing like this is dual core 2.4 with 2 gig of RAM.
Unless you're running Vista, in which case you probably need a quad core.
Yeah, it does actually say you need a 2.8 with a minimum, I think, of 3 gig of RAM. So this machine is basically entry level for doing this kind of stuff, and it works absolutely fine.
It'd be high time that we went out.
But it disappoints me slightly that my machine's just entry level for doing something, and it's brand new. Unbelievable. So you could use this to put together your home movie, and you can edit this, and you can sort of. I don't quite know how to use it because I've never bothered sort of playing around with it for long enough. To do your editing, but I found that it crashed a couple of times on me, which when I'm doing editing is just not acceptable.
Yeah, I used some Pinnacle software before when I think it was an old analog capture device, and that was crap.
Yeah, and I have to say, I'm not happy. I wasn't happy with it. So, I mean, I can do things like cutting and get rid of stuff, and that's exactly what I want to be able to do, because I'm using this for one job and one job only. So if you bear with me 1 second. Okay, so what I've actually done is I've loaded in and created this project called Car Journey. And what that essentially is that's all those little files that I copied across. And each file is where I literally start the record and then stop it again. And it just creates them as little files. And you view them on this device I was showing you earlier, wasn't I? As they're like photos.
Yeah.
And you can just scan across and press play on any one of them or delete one of them, and it frees up the space, which over tape just makes life so nice. So what I'm going to do is I've brought this into Pinnacle, and for me, Pinnacle isn't good enough for doing editing. So what I'm actually now going to do is I'm going to export this out. So I'm going to go to Make Movie.
God, I remember this. This is so similar.
Which, for me, the word make movie is just... Okay, so we've had that crash once already on us, so I had to kill that and I had to go back in. So it's not robust. I mean, I appreciate I've got screen capture running as well in the background.
It can't help so much, can it?
It can't help, but I don't know. I'm pretty certain that when we run Vegas, we're not going to run into this problem, but we'll come on to that in a minute. So what I'm going to do is I'm now going to export this... these imported files, and I'm going to export them out as literally just straight video. And by doing so, it makes it a lot easier to then use another application to do your editing.
So has the format changed? Is it still that AVCHD now?
Well, the inbound file is that, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to convert that in the outbound. We're going from digital to digital.
Yeah.
But it just means that by putting it into another format, I can use a slightly more advanced package to do my editing. Because as you've seen from this, it's crashed once already, and it's not great. So if I go into the settings, what I'm essentially going to do is I'm just going to put it out as regular MPEG, MJPEG, and they've actually got a codec now for putting this out under HD, which is built into Pinnacle, in their fairness. So I'm going to put it out at 1280 by 720. So that's going to take that 1440 by 1080, and we're going to scale it down to something a bit more workable with, because 1280 by 720 is... really, in my mind and for computing at the moment, is the standard, isn't it? So I'm going to literally just export that out and say okay on that. And what that will actually now do is we go to here, create, and we shall create on desktop Journey and make movie in progress. So that's exporting the AVCHD file out. So we'll let that finish.
How long is that? Is that like a real-time process or?
Ooh, no.
That's 20 seconds it's doing now, is it?
19 seconds of footage, and it's going it's going about 13 frames a second. So it's half speed. Which, to be honest with you, is not so bad. I mean, on a machine like this, it's not so bad. But we are rendering out high-definition footage. Yeah. So let that render out. Cool, and that's done that one piece of file. So we'd export all that out, and we ordinarily do the whole lot or everything that we wanted to use. So as far as I'm concerned, that's all I'm going to use Pinnacle for, and I'm going to close that down.
Riddance.
And let's put that onto the desktop, and we can actually see.
So I've got this new high definition Panasonic.
So that's scaled down here at the moment. So there's my footage come in. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to actually use a pretty, a slightly more powerful application. And again, not that expensive. I was really quite surprised by the pricing for Sony Vegas products. And again, they have like an entry level, a mid-range. And the mid-range really is suitable for podcasters like us, where we need to have multiple streams, anything up to 100 streams, and run at HD. So, and that's $119. So for me,
you couldn't do that HD thing, Pinnacle. You still got to use Pinnacle.
Yeah. Now this is really where I've got to sort of say how bad I think Sony is, or maybe not so bad, but they've got their own range of camcorders that support AVC HD, and they work perfectly and can import into Vegas no problems. If this was a Sony, this application and the Sony, they talk to each other. And Sony said they are going to support all the other manufacturers, but just haven't got round to doing it yet, because it's all still pretty cutting edge. So I think they will do it, and ultimately I'll be able to edit this directly in here without needing to do any conversions, but for the time being, can't do it. So if we go and take a look, what we should be able to find is that I've got in my video editing, let's get into my documents. So what I can now do is, this is the entire file edited out, and it's pretty large. I mean, if we go and take a quick look, because I didn't quite... It's 10.6 gig, and that is... Well, you say that, but that's not actually so bad, because if I'm capturing on here, by the time I've finished in standard definition, that's going to be something approaching 10 gig for the show. So this is a raw version, but with using a high-def codec. So this is all HD, and as you can see, it's coming in, and it's really quite perky to be able to jump around. And what I can do is I can play that, no problem.
Get myself a coffee at Starbucks.
Oh yes, please.
Oh. So as you can see, I can jump around really quite snappily on a large file and view it down here. Now, I've been playing with Vegas only for about a week. As you know, I've been using Adobe Premiere, Premiere Pro up until now to do the shows. I looked at CS3, and I've got to tell you, it's a lot of money for very little. It doesn't support AVC. I could only get one 1280 by 720 stream on this powerhouse of a machine. This I can have. I've had up to three simultaneously playing without flaws. So I mean, Sony really have done a good job in producing this software. They're just not seen as one of the big names in non-linear editing, but dude, it's a good application, and I've only been playing with it for about a couple of weeks, and did a promo video for my company, which went really well at an exhibition. So started to sort of get to grips with it. So we can do things like if I go into see what I'll do. I shall go into here. And let's pull up the effects. So the first thing that I might want to do with this is actually rotate it so that it's the right way around, because obviously the camera was upside down. So I can rotate that to 180. And I can do things like adjust the size of it and the positioning of the video, as you can see me doing here on the right-hand side. Literally everything that you'd want to be able to do. So I can pan it through the scrubber. So let's say, for example, at this point here, I wanted to put a split into the video. I could do that. Then I could drag that maybe over to here, put another split. Take that section of film out, drag those two together. I'll tell you what I will do, just because it's quite small anyway, is... Okay, so I've actually put it back to sort of so we can actually see what's going on here a little bit more. So if I now go over to something like, say, for example, the transitions, and what we can do, we can see here we've got loads of them. So I could do something like a dissolve between that piece and that piece. And now when we sort of pan the scrubber across here, what we could actually see...
Yeah, how well this is capturing, so... That'll be interesting to see when I get back and put this through into the editor.
So what we should be able to see now is that we'll cut, be a bit of a cut. There we go. And that was sort of a transition from large into small, when it sort of faded out and faded back in again. So, I mean, we can do all of these kinds of things using... Not just Sony Vegas, I mean, to be honest with you, any half-decent non-linear editor can do all of this and do it very, very easily. I just found that it was very, very solid. I've never had this crash on me once. I've had up to five streams. So what I did was I took all of this footage when I went out yesterday, and I put it together into a project called Journey. and I brought in some overlays, and as you can see here, I've got several sort of audio tracks, a number of video feeds, and tightened down 30 minutes into what is 4 minutes of high definition video. Because what I thought we would do is we'd put it out in true high def, because obviously when we film the show, we compress it to buggery,
yeah.
So that you get 30 minutes in a reasonable file size. But what we're going to do is we're going to put 4 minutes of video out that you've already seen.
Yeah,
That's quite good. And it's going to be 300 megabytes. But just to be able to show you really what HD can do, because we spent a lot of money on this, and we thought you should at least appreciate what it is that we bought. So I think that kind of explains a little bit the headache people are going to have if they try doing this, and certainly not to try doing it unless they've got a pretty
decent machine.
Yeah, pretty powerful computer. So that pretty much concludes that. But we'll put it out as a second stream, so this will be 54 and 54B, I guess.
Okay, sounds good.
Don't watch B before A, it'll ruin the whole thing.
But that won't work, will it? Because if they have watched B, they wouldn't have got this message.
Yeah, that's true.
You have to put it on the start of B.
Yeah.
Just don't say, don't watch this unless you watched A.
Oh, it's all too cryptic. Right, so with that, I'm going to call this episode a day, and next week's episode should be in high def.
Yeah, with the new camera.
Yeah, so we'll start filming that in the next few minutes.
Cool.
Right, see you guys later.
See ya.
Bye.
He cried himself to sleep tonight on his huge pillow.